योगचंद्राय रविकाय तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो.
In which language I should speak? Bengali Hindi. Okay, under the guidance of Guru Vaishnavas, we are performing the 84 crores Vrajamandala Parikrama. And this place where we are now, this place is Bandir, inside Bandir Barn, called Bamshi Bhat. So it's written that you had darshan of Bamshi Bhat. There are many Bamshi Bhatas in Braj, many. Bamshi means that Krishna has played the flute here and performed the Rasa Lila with the gopis. Krishna, not only he plays the flute for the Rasa Lila, also for other reasons. Also to collect the cows, to gather the cows, also Krishna would play the flute. Shastra explains. Krishna had like a necklace full of jewels, like crystals, like a japamala, like a mala, we call many small stones. So he would call the cows, counting them, and also the cows also take rest here, and Krishna also. So in the Dwapara Yuga, this banyan tree, but this banyan tree was gigantic. Gurudev used to say, even Jamuna also would flow here before. And then the Sakhas, the friends of Krishna, they would cross the Jamuna walking on these branches of this tree. So from one branch to the other side of Jamuna they could reach by the climbing on the tree, especially in the summertime. So the banyan tree gives so much coolness. So in the summertime they used to take rest here. So it's very hot here in the marsh in the like summertime. So that's why grazing the cows, the friends of Krishna and Krishna, they used to take rest under this tree. So Krishna had one mani mala, means like a necklace of many jewels, and he used to count the cows. We have also 108 beads of Tulasi mala, right? Tulasi japa mala. But Krishna has 108, this is also the same bead, but also of jewels, like crystals. So Krishna is counting the cows, which cow came or not. One time one cow didn't come. Her name was Dhabali. Her name was Chamoli. So the names of cows are so beautiful. Dhabali, Chamoli, Mridangamukhi, Ganga, Jamuna. Beautiful names they have. So one day, that cow didn't come. One cow called Chamoli didn't come. Why she didn't come? Because Krishna, when he was counting the names of the cows in his mala, his bead, he forgot to call her name. That's why she didn't come. So she did not come. She likes Krishna so much, loves Krishna so much. So she became man with man, sulky, because Krishna didn't call her. In Mansarovar, we heard, when man takes place, when you have so much love and affection for your beloved, very condensed love. So, and then the prema starts to be crooked. Just like a snake zigzagging. Just like the snake. The snake is also zigzagging, you know, walking, zigzagging way. The same way, love also is crooked. In this way. So this is man, the man's man stage, the stage of man, is actually a stage of love. In this moment the love is really condensed. When the love becomes really condensed, it's called sneha. Sneha means what? Your heart melts, this is sneha. When your heart melts, this is called sneha. When this sneha becomes even more condensed, even more condensed more, it's called pranoy. Then pranoy becomes even more condensed. It's called man.
Then
sometimes Shastra say man is after pranay, sometimes after sneha. Anyway, there are many kinds of man, Shastra explains. There is the man with cause, without cause, hetu, ahetu, uddapita man. Another is called lalit man. There are many divisions of man, Arachar is described. Especially, Srila Rupa Goswami Pad, in his book, Ujjalani Lamani, he tells about uddapita man and also lalit man. He describes them beautifully. So the cow of Krishna have a kind of love called Vivekshuna Prem. There are three kinds of love in Braj, three kinds of love. One, Vivekshuna Prem. Second, Vishramba Prem.
Vishramba Prem.
And third, Utkantamai Prem. There are many divisions of the Prem. Jiva Goswami Pada in the Sandarbhas, he describes this. So to know more, you have to read the books of our Goswamis to know more about this. If I speak everything, it takes so much time. So I was telling, once Krishna was chanting the names of the cows, counting the cows in his bead, like a necklace of bead of crystals, and he didn't call the Shyamali cow. Then Krishna played the flute and called Shyamali. And then the cow raised her front legs and running came to meet Krishna and started licking Krishna. Licking, you know, the cows, they lick for one affection. When they are giving the affection, they lick. So this place is also called Sridambar, the banyan tree of Sridam. This place is a place of separation, Biraha, Stan. First, who came? Nityananda Prabhu came here, first of all. Nityananda Prabhu came here. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here, Sridham was still here, standing. Why? Because in Dwapara Yuga, Krishna was here. And then when Krishna left from Vrindavana to Mathura, Sridham was feeling so much separation from Krishna and he couldn't tolerate it. Sridham thought, until Krishna does not come back, I'll continue staying here, I'll not go away. That's why Sridham was just staying here, under this tree, standing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when Mahaprabhu, in Kali Yuga, 500 years ago, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here. He met Sridham here. Our Shastra explains this katha. Another story here also, is a piece of separation. When Krishna was in Vrindavan, and then he left to Mathura, and then to Dwaraka. And when he went to Dwaraka, gopis lost all the hopes, gopis thought, Krishna will not come back. But Krishna told, what he told? He said, look, when Krishna left in the chariot of Akrur, Krishna told the gopis, giving hope to them. Krishna told, I will come back the day after tomorrow. After 2 days, I'll be back. Hey, gopis. Don't worry, I am going today to Mathura. Tomorrow I will kill Kamsa. And the day after tomorrow I will come back. But Krishna left and never came back. Krishna killed Kamsa. So he had to deliver Devaki Vasudeva from the jail. So Krishna did this. And also he put Ugrasena in the chariot. Then Krishna also went for 64 days. He went to the chariot, to the ashram of Sandipani Muni to study. So after that, it's not described that Krishna came to Vrindavan. According to the Bhagavatam, it's not described that Krishna came back to Vrindavan. The gopis were thinking, If Krishna was in Mathura, maybe he'll come back. That's why the gopis were still alive. Because he was in Mathura. But when he left Mathura and went to Dwaraka, then their hopes were lost. And the gopis were thinking so much biraha, separation. Shastra explains. One gopi, immersed in bhav, she reached Dwaraka and she was chastising Krishna. So our Bengali poets, they write a very beautiful bhava in their poems. What they say? Hey Krishna, you are from Braj, come back to Braj. So our poets Vaishnavas Chandidas and many other Vaishnava poets, they tell all these their transcendental poems. Hey Krishna, you're from Braj, come back to Braj. Sudam is crying. Everybody's crying. Sudam is also crying. Gopis are saying, Krishna, you became Nanda Dwarakadish.
And
you forgot us. You forgot us completely. Then gopis are like teasing Krishna. Okay, you forgot us. Okay, because our love is only sentiments. Like you say, today I love you. Tomorrow I, first day I love you. Then I beat you. Then okay, leave you. Then I will kill you. So this is the love of this world. So the gopis are telling Krishna also, like, they're like provoking Krishna. Yeah, okay, you forgot us, because our love was just sentiment, right? But how could you have forgotten your mother? How could you forget your mother? How could you forget your mother? Chaitanya Charitamrita explains. How could you forget your own mother? How could you forget your own mother? So the gopis are like provoking Krishna. They're like and saying this. How could you forget your mother? And the gopis are saying, Krishna, come back to Vrindavan. All the Vrindavas are crying for you. Let's go to Braj. Sridham is crying. Sridham is also crying. The gopis, they are crying so much, they are even tired of crying for you. Then Krishna says, okay, but what to do? If I go to Braj, how? I forgot my habits, my previous habits. Because when I was in Braj, I used to graze the cows. Always I was running behind the cows before. And I always used to walk on the dust of the Braj. But now I'm a king. I don't know how to walk on the sand, on this dust, you know. How can I go to Braj in this situation? Then gopis are saying, no. Krishna, there's no dust in Braj. Why? Because the gopis have cried so much. Everything is completely flooded by the tears of the gopis. It's just like a flood of tears. Flood of tears. Then Krishna says, if there's so much tears, then why will how will I go there? My foot will be full of mud. The kirtan is saying, very beautiful kirtan. Then Krishna says, then the gopis saying, Krishna, don't worry. Even if you have mud in your foot, don't worry. By the tears of the gopis, we'll wash your foot one more time. Then Krishna says, okay, you're saying actually that in Braj there's only a flood of tears. But I mean Mathura. How will I go to Braj? Like how? Means of transportation. Then the gopis say, we'll make a boat of the body of the gopis. Boat. And then you can, with the body of the gopis, and this way you can come from Mathura to Braj. In these beautiful kirtans, this is the space of separation, was here. Here, Krishna is eternally here. We heard, actually, because the Krishna Vrindavana never leaves Vrindavana, never. He stayed here invisible. Krishna stayed here invisible. So this is the place of Sridham. It's also called Sridham Bhart, the banyan tree of Sridham, and also Bhamshi Bhart, the banyan tree where Krishna banyan the fruit. During the day, Krishna used to graze the cows and stay here with his friends, Sakas, and perform Sakyarasa, many things. Sakyarasa, and in the evening, he used to meet the Sakis and perform Rasa Lila here. The time of Krishna Lila, this Vamshi Bhart, this tree was so big, gigantic. Krishna used to climb on this tree and call the gopis. Srimad Bhagavatam explains.
Jagau karo baam disha manoharam.
So the song clean. Actually, Krishna was telling the names, each name of the gopis, and Krishna was calling them. So Shastra explains, and the commentary also explains. Here, a beautiful Rasa Lila used to happen here. You see, actually, this is a very big place, very big place. Actually, Jogamaya has this potency. She can make the place shrink and also big. Jogamaya can make the places big and small. Jogamaya can do this. So Krishna performed Rasa Lila here, doing the Rasa. Then the gopis say, "Oh, we are thirsty, Krishna. Give us water to drink." Then what did Krishna do? You saw on the way. What did you see? Shyamtalaya. Yes. Did you see the Shyamtalaya? Okay, so Krishna, what did he do there? With his foot, he dig a bigger well. So this is called Shyamtalaya. So then the water was coming from Patal. The water coming up the water from spilling out from the earth, and then the gopis drank the water. It's called Shyamtalaya. So, some people say those who don't have kids, they drink this water, they have kids. I don't know about this. Or some people, if you have some disease, also if you take that water, all diseases are removed. People say that the water of that well is very pure, very, very glorious. So we just pray that we have Krishna Bhakti. This is a place, a divine place. Guru Vaishnavas, they come here, they bring us here to have darshan. In Dwapara Yuga, there were beautiful pastimes of Krishna. And in Kali Yuga also, Nityananda Prabhu and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they have come here also, performing Namas and Kirtan. Then later on, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur came here, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada came here also, Srila Bhakti Pragyani Keshava Goswami Maharaj came here. Srila Gurudev Vaishnava Narayan Goswami Maharaj came here. Srila Vamana Goswami Maharaj, Dipkarma Goswami Maharaj came here. Many Vaishnavas came here. It's a divine transcendental place, you have seen. So if you touch the dust of this place, Krishna Prema will appear in your hearts. In the Brihad Bhagavatam, it's explained. Actually, Narada Rishi himself, he took a benediction from Krishna. If any person takes this dust of Raj, goes to the place of pastimes, take this dust and put on your head and listen to the Harikatha of the place, what will happen? Which kind of prema? You'll get the prema, the highest prema of the gopis. This prema that even great demigods and Uddhava are so eager to attain, you'll be able to attain. Even the Shrutis are searching for this path. You will be able to attain this path. And this transcendental divine Gopi Prema will appear in your hearts. So we have seen the darshan of the temple there. You saw Nityananda Prabhu there. Also Sridham Prabhu also you saw. Krishna also. So all these are divine transcendental place. So we do pranam. We are going now back to Gopinath Bhavan. It's almost 12:45, almost. It's at least, it will take us 1 hour to get back to the temple. So in the evening will be Harikatha. We'll be describing details, everything in the evening Harikatha. Be careful with your phone mobile. Many thieves stealing phones. So many thieves are here to steal your phone. Be careful. Be careful. They even take the phone in your pocket, especially the Western devotees.